Hey there to all my beautiful divine feminines out there. Good morning. Happy Valentine's Day. I don't know if you guys just watched my reading from this morning, but it's interesting. I wanted to follow it up with because I was guided to pull a soul, we call this soul messages. That's what they're telling me. Soul messages for the divine feminine. And this is coming from spirit. And it's so interesting what cards came out, you guys. It relates so much to the reading I just did about self-love. And that's going to really be the theme of today. And I was kind of surprised, you know, I didn't get like super lovey-dovey cards. And it's all about the divine feminine just stepping into her power. And so again, I think that, you know, this is a message for some of you. Again, I feel like it's for my single, fearless, you know, in separation from their divine masculine, divine feminine. So if this resonates, please, you know, like, comment below. I know that this resonates with me. I feel like this was also a message for me. And so was the message before, even though my divine masculine isn't married. If you guys go back and watch that video, I felt like the divine feminine energy, and that was very much related to my energy right now. So again, you know, take what resonates, throw out what doesn't, but let's get into it. Okay, so these are soul messages for the divine feminine from spirit. All right, so I pulled one card from each of the decks that I have here on the table, and wow, the energy came through like boom, fire. Like the divine feminine is on fire, okay? Knight of Wands, again, passion, moving forward, you know, kind of in this energy of I'm going to go out and get what I want, okay? And you've got the High Priestess, because I know, I'm all knowing. The Spirit is talking to me right now. They are guiding me. I am knowing where I stand in my power. I know where I stand in my life, and I am going for it, okay? And then we got the fight. This is from the Akashic Tarot. We get the Five of Forces, summer and winter. And so I want to read this definition to you because I absolutely love it. Okay. It says, and I'm not going to read the whole definition, but it says, this cycle is a perfect time to create a smiling, self-loving energy and project it outward for the world to see. Also, don't be surprised if a trip is coming your way. This card implies movement of some kind, so get ready. And again, this is, you know, I feel like the divine feminine is just moving into her power. And then we got release your ex. The time has come to clear your energy. And I feel like you guys are doing this. You're releasing all of those things that don't serve you anymore. It doesn't necessarily mean like an ex-boyfriend or an ex-husband or an ex-lover. It means releasing all of those energies that don't serve you anymore. Because again, King of Fire, okay? King of Fire, you guys. Oh my gosh, and I'm going to read a little bit of this definition because that's like the King of Wands right there. Oops. Ground and focus your passion, okay? Be dauntless. Remain involved from start to finish. Be more than an ideas person. Every leader is a part of a team. Okay, the King of Fire is a charismatic leader. He is passionate and is passion is something others find inspiring because it is focused, grounded, and creative. He is the perfect team leader. He can draw to him the people who are necessary for a project to be completed, and every single person will want to play a part to help bring his vision to life. The King of Fire is also fearless, dauntless, in fact. He is lion-hearted and the vital heartbeat of his court. He is not afraid of hard work, but he also respects and moves through his day with awareness that he is only a part of the whole. I mean, wow. And then we get the Joan of Arc, okay? The Warrior of Light. I mean, warrior energy, you guys. This is amazing. I have a steel-like faith in myself. The angels armor me with conviction, okay? And then Blossom, okay? So you are blossoming from, and I feel like, again, there's this very like vibrant warrior energy, this strong energy, but then you get this Blossom card and it's like you're grounding this energy. This is not going to be like, I'm going to take no prisoners energy, you know, like Queen of Swords. Like, I'm not feeling that energy. I'm feeling passion and grounded, in this warrior energy. And then we got sobriety. And it's so funny because I said in my earlier video, like, I'm totally going to have wine tonight. And I am super excited to have wine. And I'm going to order myself a steak dinner. And I'm going to buy myself some flowers. So I laughed when the sobriety card came up. But again, like, this doesn't mean, you know, not having a glass of wine or not enjoying, you know, enjoying some beverages. Like, that's okay. Okay, so sobriety to me just meant, again, releasing all of those toxins from your life. Like, releasing any bad negative energy that's been holding you back and holding you down. And then we get the elephant spirit, okay? This is learn from the past. So again, releasing those past energies that no longer serve you. And you're learning from all of that. You're like, no, you know what? Like, I'm not going to live in that state anymore. I'm not going to let those things affect me. And I am learning from, you know, I don't want to say mistakes because I feel like nothing is really a mistake in life. You know, like, we all make decisions and we're all guided to make the decisions that we do. And it may seem like a mistake at the time, but everything happens for a reason. I know that sounds cliche, but again, you know, learning from the past and moving forward. There's so much movement here. And I love it. Divine Feminine. You guys are awesome. Okay. And then we got the number 11 card from the Rumi Oracle deck, Sacred Convergence. And I'm going to read this to you guys because this was such a beautiful way to end the reading. And I was so, so, so excited. And my book fell on the ground. So, hi. Sorry, I have no makeup on. It's like 5:30 in the morning. I couldn't sleep. I woke up at 4 and I had all these ideas running through my head. So I know it's going to be a great day, like lots of good energy. Okay. So Sacred Convergence. Sacred Convergence indicates a coming together of souls in alignment with a greater cause. Okay. So that's like union, guys. That's union. This greater cause is both personal and impersonal. There is an aspect of joining together for common purpose, although that purpose may not immediately be obvious at a level of day-to-day consciousness. That common soul purpose may be to lift each other into greater love and self-belief, to shed fear and open the heart, filling each individual soul with more holy fire for its personal, passionate purpose. You'll have a sense when this process is happening. There will be a coming together of you with like-minded souls who hail from all walks of life, and yet together through some invisible genius, you will help each other. You may simply be dancing in the same room or singing in a group, attending a class or workshop, or just visiting the same beach or parkland. Okay, that's really weird, and I'm going to talk about that in a second. But at that moment, there will be a sense of something coherent and nourishing happening at a far greater level. Wow, guys. Okay, this oracle has come to you because you are part of a greater sacred convergence happening now. Perhaps you have already sensed its progression, or perhaps it is not obvious to you, but the effect, whether obvious or subtle, will be important to your soul development and divine awakening. You are being asked to drop defenses and barriers towards groups of people that feel good for you. However, those that dampen your spirits or drag you down are to be dispensed with. Again, releasing those toxic people, releasing negative energies. No matter what games of blame or manipulation they may play to keep you coming back for more, no, that shall not do for your soul growth now. Just step away. Okay? This oracle comes with a special message. Perhaps you have been thinking about shedding lower vibrational connections based in the ego world of power games, sabotage, manipulation, and fear. Perhaps you've already begun this process or even shed so many you are fearing. You might have overpruned to be left with nothing and no one else. Do not fear. Feisty angel of love. Oh my God, that is you. You are the feisty angel of love. I couldn't have even said it better myself. I'm amazed. Your truth is prevailing. Your truth is prevailing. You cannot stay in a vibration of fear if you want to dwell in a vibration of love. Okay. Oh my gosh, guys, what a beautiful, beautiful message and a beautiful way to end this. Okay. So I really do feel like a very strong union energy here too, because you're coming into your power and you're having your awakening. You are the feisty angel of love. And one thing I want to touch on, guys, and I asked Spirit for guidance about this morning. So, I live very close to Parkland, where the Parkland shooting happened a year ago today. And you guys, I'm an empath, and it affected me very, very strongly. I didn't know anyone who was personally affected directly by it, but I have friends of friends who were, who lost their children on that day, this day a year ago. And I didn't want to let that negative energy about what happened, affect my day today or Valentine's Day. You know, I wanted to just like come out and give messages of love and guidance. And I just read that definition, and the word Parkland was in there, you guys. I'm getting emotional again, because I feel that that was divinely guided. So just, I don't want to dwell on it at all, because again, it was such a sad day, especially for my community. But I really feel like the message is go out and love with full force today, guys. Love yourself. Love your neighbor. Sorry. Oh, geez. I need to get it together. And there's so much love and there's so much good in the world. And honestly, I will tell you, after the shooting happened, our community came together so strong. It was unbelievable to see the work of the angels being done here on earth. So you guys, go out and celebrate love today. However you're going to do it, just do it. Okay. Do it for Parkland. I had no idea that message was even going to come out, but obviously it was meant to. So I'm sending you guys so much love and light. I'm wishing you the best day ever. I'm sorry I've been so emotional. I promise I won't be this emotional in my readings, but sometimes I get overwhelmed with the messages from Spirit. So thank you so much, Spirit, and thank you guys for watching my channel. Love and light to you all. Bye.